About birth control today and how it could be causing more harm than good.
Joining us live this afternoon, Dr. Jacqueline Paykel from the Medical College of Wisconsin. Let's start with the easy question, the difference between the high and the low doses. There are two different levels you can get here.
The magic number is 20. So if it's 20 or less, it's a low dose. If it's 20, as far as the estrogen component, if it's greater than 20, as far as the estrogen is concerned, then it's considered a standard dose.
And why that difference of between low and high doses? Do some people just not react well to too much estrogen?
Right. Well, the thinking there is that the estrogen is the problem as far as that which will cause side effects. So headaches, blood clot formation, stroke, that sort of thing. So the lower estrogen, the better, some were thinking anyway.
And that's when you say it could be more harmful. That's what you're talking about, the headaches, blood clots.
Right.
Are these reversible? Like, let's say you've been on birth control for a number of years and then you stop taking it.
Yes, but I think that the new information that came out is that the low-dose pills are actually contributing to chronic pelvic pain. And so this is something that is not known at all. This is new research, and it's pain with chronic pelvic pain, but also with sexual activity.
So even if you're on low dose, you might not be symptom-free, and you could still be causing problems for your body.
Right, and actually the standard doses that are greater than 20, those do not have the same problems.
And this is a situation where if you're committed to being on the pill, you just need to work with your doctor, suffer through some of the side effects to figure out where that sweet spot is for you.
Right. I mean, we see this a lot. I actually work in the sexual health clinic for the medical college, and if somebody's coming in under the age of 30, it's really, it's a big problem.
How long should a woman be on birth control?
Well, if they are a smoker, they should stop by the age of 35, but if they're not, around the age of 50 usually.
Benefits to taking the pill. I mean, we've talked about the side effects. What's the upside here?
Well,
besides the obvious one.
Yeah, there's lots of benefits, right? It's more dangerous to be pregnant than to be on the birth control pill. But besides that, irregular bleeding, pain with your menstrual flow, it may decrease the risk of having ovarian cysts or ovarian cancer.
So if you're having unexplained pain, you're a female, you're on birth control pills, you should look at that as a possible cause.
Absolutely. In this particular study, 25% of women on the low dose had pelvic pain associated with the pill.
Is this something that doctors know about and would look at? I mean, it kind of seems like you might have to navigate your way through the system to kind of pinpoint what's going on.
Right. So I'm a specialist in this area, and the patients that I see have generally seen at least 3 to 4 providers otherwise.
And these are the reasons why, despite the fact this is such a pervasive drug in society, it's still not over the counter. You have to go to a medical professional to get this filled because there are so many problems that could come up.
Yes, it's very important, and family history is also very important as far as migraine headaches and clot formation. So it's really important to involve a provider.
Dr. Paykel, thanks so much. Got a question for the experts? Email them. Ask the expert today's TMJ4.com. You can also leave a voicemail. That number is on your